You've been doing this a while now. Is it still fun to do?
It's actually more fun now than it has been in the past, to be honest. I enjoy it more.
Why is that?
I don't know. I think since becoming a mother, you put things into a different perspective and you realise actually making music, writing music, performing, it's fun.
Do you think that's also because there's less pressure on you? Because first and foremost, you're a mum, aren't you? You know, so
yeah,
actually anything
exactly.
you do career-wise, it's like, if it goes well, then great. But at the end of the day, I'm still a mum and that's my
totally.
Main role.
Totally, yeah. And it becomes kind of secondary. So then you can just enjoy it rather than stress about it. Before it, that was like the main focus in my life. Now he is.
Yeah.
Well, we were saying as well, obviously, with Girls Aloud back in the day, it's a testimony to how hard you guys all work, because nowadays, you know, like if a single's out, whatever, you can tweet it, it's out there. You guys started, there was none of that.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? It was a lot harder for you all back then, and you smashed it even then, do you know what I mean?
I never thought about it like that, actually. We did used to work crazy hours, though. We worked really hard, yeah.
You did go on a bit of a journey, didn't you? But it was so different. Like you say, we had Katy Perry on the show this week and she was saying it was the worst and best thing that's ever been invented, which is social media. Do you agree with
that? Yeah. I'd go with the worst.
Yeah. just the worst.
Just the worst.
Hey, just talking about being a mum then and how it becomes not a priority, you're going to be a nightmare when you come back, Jim, because you're not switched on most of the time, are you? To be honest.
Not getting up at four.
How long are you taking off?
I'm going to take 6 months off, so I'll be back in January.
Nice.
But I'm going to come back to a different... I'm going to do the drive time slot. I can't do the 4 o'clock starts with a newborn.
No.
Because I want to be there. And my mum's brilliant. She's retired, so she's going to be coming living with me for a bit. But I want to be there in the mornings, knowing when they wake up. I want them to see me and no one else.
I know.
That sounds quite selfish.
It does not sound selfish at all. It's totally natural.
You're thinking you get some lie-ins. Yeah. We all know that you're lying. Let You, it's from Cheryl, it's brand new. She's on the show with us this morning.
Cheryl, that was written with Nicola, was it again? Nicola Roberts?
Yeah, it was.
And we could tell because, remember what I said last time, your songs, with it, you always sound like you're just chatting in a room with your girls and a bottle
That's
of wine.
That's exactly what it is.
And every time I listen to them, I think, I needed that song a few years ago.
And then dance like that together, though, whilst you're doing it, do you?
And also, it's like the stuff I think that you've written with Nicola just seems to be very, very honest and open, which I guess is sort of testament to your relationship together.
Exactly.
The fact that you can just write and, you know, you're not trying to impress anybody. You're writing with somebody who you know inside out and she knows you inside out and you can just be completely, you know.
Open?
Yeah.
It's conversational. And also there was another girl in there who was having major boy drama, so I was just wringing the hell out of her. And we were just having a laugh,
I love that. Can we talk about your video? There's a very handsome man in that video. And I mean, he is a beautiful man. Did you and Nicola decide to sit down and do the casting for this video? Be honest, was it all you?
It was all me.
Yeah, like Pex Factor.
I did do the casting for obvious reasons.
I wouldn't blame you. It'd be part of the fun of it, isn't it? Get your mates over and judge these guys as they came in.
There was a few, actually, you know. I was like, okay, it was hard to pick, but he won.
Did you have to get it down to a final 50? Like, get him to boot camp.
You can go to judges' homes.
It took us like 10 weeks to narrow it down, I'm sure. When you're not doing this, when you're not promoing, are you watching Love Island, which started this week?
I will be, yes.
Are you into it? Are you a fan? Or do you feel like you're forced to watch it by everyone else?
I feel like I'm a fan.
Okay.
Yeah, but I don't know about this new series. We'll have to say, wait till it really kicks in.
Mm.
I like when the true stuff starts happening.
Yeah.
When they start getting down.
Yeah, like, when they get annoyed with each other.
What do you mean, when they start getting down?
Or like when they switch and they do like the unbelievable stuff where you're like, how do you switch from that guy to that guy and... 2 seconds.
It's the gasp moments that are going to come, isn't it? Like last year where they kind of go, no, do you know, suddenly the guy who was with her for what, 4 weeks is then coupling up with somebody else?
Mm. Yeah.
It's when you're getting mugged off, isn't it? You've got to know all the lingo. It's just muggy everywhere. Listen, before you go, on the show this morning, we've been talking about this thing that we've been talking about the fact that you can phone or text the wrong person sometimes with disastrous effects. Have you ever done that?
I feel like I have, but I don't recall the outcome, but I'm sure I have.
Yeah.
Or that feeling when you think you have and your heart sinks a little bit.
I had this one yesterday, Cheryl, where I thought I was ringing my builder friend who's called Lawrence. And instead, I got a message back from another Lawrence who is a multimillionaire who runs a racing car team, kind of going, much as the invite to come and do some jobs at your house is really appealing. And I thought, oh no, I've rung the wrong one.
I mean, it could be even worse than that. I was once in the studio with a producer who had meant to text someone about the artist and texted the artist while he was in the room.
There you go. There
I mean, and go. not good stuff. Like, this guy's a real, you know, bad words.
It's very difficult to recover from that, isn't it?
Well, he said he walked out. He said, really? I literally sent the email, heard his phone ping and left the room. And then like just thought about it for a minute about what on earth I was going to do. And then he said he just had to fess up.
It's dangerous.
He said,
isn't
I literally
it?
Went in there and went, look, mate, you've got an email on your phone that is about you, but was not intended for you. Can you imagine?
Who was it? Can you say who it was?
No, they probably know who they are, but I'm not going to. I shouldn't think I should out them.
It's when you see the send and you can't do anything about it.
No,
and it's like,
I know.
Don't go.
The one time your Wi-Fi works and you don't want it to. Yes. Sending, and you're like, no, you should throw your phone.
Cheryl, it's always a pleasure to have you on the show. Thank you for your time and the best of luck with the new single.
Thank
it's called
you.
Let You. It's going to be brilliant, I'm sure.
Thanks so much.
Cheryl on Hits Radio.
Thank you.
Oh, yeah.
This is Hits Radio Breakfast.